Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to look at setting up a quantity chart inside of Dashpivot. The quantity chart is used to track numerical quantities recorded inside table fields in your templates. So really common examples include tracking labor hours or costs or production quantities over time. And in this video, we're going to look at tracking some labor hours and also some production quantities that we're recording in a daily report or site diary template. And as we're running through this, just keep in mind that you can actually create quantity charts for any type of template that you have, so long as you have a table field that has a column that is set as a number column. So that's really important, because if we're not recording our data that way, the quantity chart can't actually pull that information and visualize it for us. I will also say that you can create quantity charts both at a company level in your organization's analytics section, but also at a project team level, which is what we'll be doing in this video. So here we are in Dashpivot. We're looking at a site diary template, and we have many forms that have been filled out so far. If we open one of them, I just want to show you exactly where our data is going to come from. So we're going to look at pulling information from this table here, production. You can see that we've got a column for the work activity. It's really important later on, if we want to break down our quantities by our work activity, that it's set up as a drop-down list. And then we have a column for the actual quantity associated with that work activity. And it's also linking it to our WBS link. So we have our quantity linked to two different variables in this table. So we're going to look at tracking production. We're also going to take a look at tracking labor. So you can see here we have a table where we've got the names of people per this subcontractor, and then we have the start and finish times for these people, and you can see the total hours that they've worked. So we've got a handy formula column here, which is just calculating the difference between the start and finish time to give us our number for our total hours. This is what our quantity chart is going to look at. It's going to look at this column, and again, because we've got a drop-down list for the person's name, it's actually going to associate this quantity with that person's name and also with this cost code dropdown that we have here. So pretty much any dropdown menus that you have in your table, the values that are selected in those dropdowns for that row will be associated with that quantity. So 7.5 will be associated with Ben, 7.5 with Daniel, 6 with Mario, 6.5 with Felix, and so on and so forth for as many rows as you create. So it's really important to keep this in mind and set up your template this way so that we can extract that information and plot it using those quantity charts. Great, so let's now take a look at this information in the register view. Before we look at the chart itself, I just want to show you that in our register view, we can see we've got a row for each of our forms, and the quantity chart is going to pull this information here. So this is just showing us, as you'll recall from our template, we had a table for production, and that's what we're looking at here. So these three columns, work activity, quantity, and WBS link, this column in the middle for quantity is where our chart is going to pull its information from. And likewise for labor hours. So it's this column here for total hours, which is going to be plotted. And it's going to associate this value, or these values, with any of the variables that are selected in that table. So for this number here, 7.5, it's going to associate that with this cost code and with this person. And likewise for our production quantities, it's going to associate this number with excavation and this WBS link. But in addition to that, not only is it associating that with the information that in that table row, but also with the date that we're entering onto our form. So this shift date that we have here, it's associating that data with this date. So now let's go to the analytics and take a look at setting up a quantity chart to plot this information. So here we have, in analytics, we have a couple of dashboards already set up, and each of the dashboards has a couple of charts. So we're just going to build upon what's already in here. So let's first look at production. So you can see we already have some quantity charts in here, and they have different filters and settings applied. We're going to run through all of them by setting up our own chart. So let's go ahead and click this green button to add a chart. We get to pick what type of chart, and in this video, we're going to focus on the quantity option. So click on that. And we have to tell Dashpivot where the information is going to come from that's going to populate this quantity chart. So let's pick our template. It's just our site diary. And then by default, it will select the first table and the first possible column that can be tracked. So luckily for us, it's selected the production table and it has selected the quantity column. So if you recall, on our form, we have our production table and our quantity column. And so that's where that information is coming from. Now you can see that it's plotted it automatically. We've got some blue bars for each of the days. So you can see along the x-axis, we've got each day. And on the y-axis, we've got the actual quantity that has been recorded. And if we hover on any of the bars, we can see the total quantity. Now we should complete the rest of these settings. So for time frame, we've selected all time by default, but you could change this. You could maybe you only want to look at the data from the current month or the last quarter or last year, etc. And you can visualize this information either daily or weekly, or if you've got a large enough data set, monthly is also an option. But in our case, we've just got a couple of weeks worth of data and we're going to display it daily. And we're displaying it as a bar chart at the moment, but we do have some other options. We could display it as a line chart or as a area chart. And this gets a little more interesting after we've applied a breakdown. So far we haven't selected anything. So we just get the single color showing us the total volume so far. Let's just go back to bar chart before we apply breakdown, but let's, let's take a look at the breakdown options. In this menu, we have some metadata about the form. So the person who actually filled out the form, we could click on that and we could see who's actually created the forms. You can see that we've got some forms from Henry and from Daniel over time. But we've also got some other variables that we can break our chart down by. Some of them are the list fields that we have on the template. So for example, the location and the weather. But we've also got other variables that are contained inside that table, such as the work activity and WBS link, which, as you'll recall, are the two columns that have a drop-down list in them. So this is probably the most interesting information for us to look at, because we want to look at the quantities for different work activities. So let's click on that option. And instantly we can see that we have different values for the different work activities and different colors representing those. So on this day we have excavation was 50 cubic meters. We have concrete poured was 8 cubic meters. And then we have a quantity that's been recorded that doesn't actually have something selected. So this would be an area where we want to actually go back to this form and figure out what information was actually missing. But for everything else, you can see we don't have any other orange areas. So everything else has an activity associated with it. So we've got purple and yellow and orange, and blue representing the different work activities. So this is really handy. We can see that breakdown per day, and we can identify days where maybe there wasn't any activity completed or any quantity recorded for that activity at least. So on this day here, on the 18th of Jan, we can see that there was no conduit installed on that day or on the 20th. So if we're expecting to see some quantities for that day, it then begs the question, you know, why is there no quantity recorded? You know, what happened that day? So it's much more insightful to use the quantity chart to view this information rather than trawling through your register. And so the last option is the S-curve. And if we turn that on, this is effectively overlaying the total, the cumulative quantity as a line, and also show us the bars on the same chart. So we're getting sort of best of both worlds here. And that's the S-curve is only an option that is available for the bar chart. If we select the line chart, we don't have the S-curve, but because we're breaking it down by work activity, we're seeing the total quantity for each of those work activities over time. And with the area chart, it's actually stacking all of these values cumulatively over time, which doesn't really make a whole lot of sense for us because we're comparing excavation and concrete poured and conduit installed. But just know that it's there. This is sometimes useful if you were looking at total labor hours, which we'll see in just a sec. So there's plenty of options. And the last thing that I'll point out is that we have some filters down the bottom as well, which can be applied to specify specifically which forms we want to consider on our chart. So maybe we only want to consider the work activity values, the quantities, where the location is zone 2. And so now this is going to show us something quite different because now we're only considering the quantities in zone 2 and not zone 1 as well. We can apply as many filters as we want, actually. So we could now, if we wanted to look at where the work activity is only excavation, now we're only looking at the excavation in zone 2. We can see that there. If we remove this first filter, we can and break it down by location, we can now look at the excavation total quantities per zone. So that's quite interesting to look at over time as well. And of course, the different chart types, the different show as options, can give us different insights as well. So we strongly recommend just having a play around and figuring out what works best for you. There's plenty of ways to slice and dice this data, and you'll just want to figure out what is the most important information that you want to see on your project with your team. So now that we've had a look at tracking production, let's take a look at tracking labor. So let's look at tracking our labor, and by default it's selected total hours again, which is great. And you can see that we have our breakdown is already turned on, which is great for us. Let's keep this information the same. So our time frame is the same, our interval is the same. We'll visualize this as a bar chart. And in terms of the breakdown, we might want to break it down by the person's name instead of the location. And let's see what that looks like. So quite colorful. You can see that the different colors represent different people. We can just hover on each of these blocks here, and we can see the quantity for that person. And you can see the legend here. And so we can see week by week, who's working on what days and how long did they work for. We can see that information over time. Maybe we want to see cumulatively how many hours each person has worked and the overall labor hours for that project. The area chart is probably the most appropriate option to select here, because we can see that we've worked probably getting close to 700 hours in total over the course of January. And if we hover on here, we can actually see which people have worked the most hours over time. And again, if we wanted to look at a specific person, we can apply a filter in here and say maybe we only want to look at Chris's hours because he worked quite a large number of hours. And maybe we only want to look at, or maybe we want to then break that down by location. So here we can see the breakdown of the hours that Chris has worked in two different zones on our project. So there's different ways to dig into the data and extract some insights and track your project's progress and those quantities over time. And just a couple of things to finish up. You can rename the chart. So there is a default chart name which is applied, but you can edit that. So maybe we want to change this to total labor hours for Chris, which is what we see down here. So we can change the name. And these quantity charts can be created both at a project team level, which is what we've done in this video, but also at a company level. So if you wanted to look at all of the data across your whole company, if you're using a site diary template across the whole company and every project, you can create this quantity chart at a at the company level, and then you've got some additional options then at your disposal to break down by project or team. And you can apply that in the breakdown, or you can apply that as a filter. And you can, again, just dig into the data just a little bit more than you can at the project team level. And that's how you can set up a quantity chart. If you get stuck, we do have some online help articles which you can read. And our live chat team is available to help if you have any questions or can't find something. You can just open up the live chat and flick us a message. So I hope that this video has been useful, and as always, thanks for watching.